Ayurveda and spirituality are inseparably linked to each other. In fact, for curing many of the diseases, Ayurveda uses the principles of faith and spirituality. Because when man is physically and mentally unwell, then along with medicines, he or she definitely needs a spiritual guide to inspire them back to health. Practices like meditation and praying are sources of strength for an ailing person, which could help get rid of various diseases. So come, let's see Ayurveda from a spiritual point of view.
Namaskar. Welcome to Eternal Health. The topic of this lecture is Ayurveda and spirituality. Ayurveda teaches us how to live in a natural balance. This natural balance is not limited to body and mind, but also refers to the soul. Yes, because human beings are not only physical body and mind, they also have a soul. In addition to this, this natural balance also extends to the earth, to the universe. This means we have to be in a harmonious situation or a harmonious balance with the earth. Everything on the earth, all the creatures, all the plants, stones, everything on the earth has to be in a complete natural balance. Even God, the creator of the universe, has to be in a natural balance. We have to maintain this natural balance. In the Vedic tradition, we have a very nice Sanskrit shloka, which says Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam, which actually means that this world is one big family. This universe is one big family. It not only limits the family to the human beings only, but everything in this universe is a part of our family, including God. We have seen a number of cases. So many people come to my clinic, and even otherwise, you might have encountered so many people who are physically all right. There's nothing wrong with their body. Every kind of test they undergo is normal. But they're not satisfied. They're not contented. Who is not contented? If the body is healthy, which means the mind should also be relaxed, then who is not contented? This is the soul. The soul is a very prominent part of this human structure, and we have to recognize what is soul or spirit and what is spirituality, means what does the soul likes. So this is important part of Ayurveda, and Ayurveda, when discusses about health or balance, it is referring not only to the physical or the mental balance, but also the spiritual balance. Actually, are nourishing the five elements of the body. The five elements of the body are earth, water, fire, air, and space. So the five seeds and the five elements makes it 10. Then there are five knowledge acquiring senses, which are the eyes, ears, nose, tongue, and the skin. Then there are five working senses, which are the hands, the feet, the genitals, the speech, the excretory organs. So 5 and 5, 10, and 10, 20. These are 20 constituents. Then 11th sense is the mind, and mind is a both working sense as well as a knowledge acquiring sense. Then on top of mind, there is ego, and on top of ego is intelligence, and on top of intelligence is soul. So this is the normal construction of this human being. For those of you who do not know, there can be diseases in this human being even at the level of the ego. If there is something imbalanced at the level of ego, you can have diseases. Of course, in Ayurveda, we do believe that if the intelligence doesn't function, we can have diseases. Even at the level of the soul, most people think soul cannot become sick, but like arthritis is a physical disease, dementia or insomnia is a mental disease. Similarly, birth and death is a spiritual disease. According to the Vedic philosophy, according to Ayurveda, the soul has to change bodies, and this is actually a very difficult situation for the soul. When the soul leaves one body and enters into another body, means death and birth is a disease for the soul. So when we talk about balance in Ayurveda, we are not just talking about the physical balance. When we define health in Ayurveda, it is very clearly described samdosha, samdhatu, samagnischa malakriya, prasanna atmendriya mana, swastha itta vidhiyate. Very nice definition, which actually explains in the first line about the physical body. Balance of doshas, vata pitta kapha, balance of all the seven tissues, balance of all the digestive fires, balance of all the excretory systems. Even this is not enough. According to our modern health, maybe this is enough. If somebody has the proper tissue formation, proper nutrition, proper elimination, proper balance of all the energies, this person can be called healthy. But in Ayurveda, we also include prasanna atmendriya mana, means your atma, which is the soul, indriya, the senses, and mana, the mind, should be happy. So Ayurveda says that each human being should understand what is the total constitution of the human being, should feed each and every constituent of the human being, and never forget that we are not the bodies, we are not the mind, we are the soul. And our eternal relation is with God. So we have to make an effort to go to our eternal home, which is the planet of God. This is what is the meaning of Ayurveda and spirituality. Because Ayurveda not only focuses on physical and mental things, but also gives us a way, shows us the path to become spiritual and become liberated eternally from this material world. Thank you very much. Namaskar.